Books are slowly becoming a luxury. Why? Because we do not need them. Today, you can access any content you need online, and print media is becoming less popular. Ever since the ancient days, books have been an important tool in mankind's evolution. Before the invention of the printing press by Gutenberg in 1439, books were written and copied. Such books became expensive and rare, especially today. Even though digitalism has made almost all books accessible, there are those whose rarity makes them a luxury to have. Such has been kept under lock in protected glass casings for public view or hidden in priceless libraries like the Vatican Archives. Hello and welcome to our channel! From papyrus reeds used in ancient Egypt to manuscripts in the Middle Ages, here is a list of the most expensive books ever sold as of 2021. Remember to give thumbs up to this video and show you support us by subscribing to the channel. Let us get started! Number 10. William Shakespeare's first folio of comedies, histories and tragedies. Commonly referred to as First Folio, this book is a collection of 36 plays by William Shakespeare published in 1623, about 7 years after his death. Today, it is considered one of the most influential books ever published. Out of 750 printed copies, only 235 are known to remain and are kept in private collections or public archives. William's colleagues, John Hemmings and Henry Condell, were the ones behind the publication. The folio is the only reliable text for 20 of the plays, including The Tempest and Twelfth Night, plays that hadn't been published before. The value of this book made it fetch $8.2 million at Christie's Auction House in New York in 2001 and $10 million in October 2020. Number 9. George Washington's annotated copy of the Constitution and Bill of Rights, 1789. On Monday, July 23, 1787, the delegates behind the Constitutional Convention decided to make some sort of order to the resolutions that have been approved to date. After printing a rough draft, the preamble began. For the 5 weeks that it took, George took notes of the changes proposed, writing them on his draft of the copy. This book remained in almost pristine condition for over 200 years. It was bought for $10.2 million by the Mount Vernon Ladies Association, which preserves George Washington's Mount Vernon estate. Number 8. The Canterbury Tales by Geoffrey Chaucer. This is a collection of 24 stories with over 17,000 lines written in Middle English by Geoffrey Chaucer. The tales are presented as part of a storytelling contest by a group of pilgrims traveling together from London to Canterbury to visit St. Thomas Becket at Canterbury Cathedral. The winner got a free meal at the Tabard Inn at Southwark upon return. It was sold at an auction for $11.1 million. Number 7. Birds of America by John James Audubon. Getting a chance to read this book transports you to a world of nature, scenery, and birds. It was printed between 1827 and 1838. John was an American ornithologist, naturalist, and painter. His book contains 435 life-size watercolors of North American birds, all in hand-engraved plates, and is considered the archetype of wildlife illustration. This book has 6 birds that are now extinct. Today, thanks to the digital library, you can see these pictures in the Audubon Digital Library. This book was sold to an art dealer for $12.6 million. Number 6. The Rothschild Prayer Book. Also known as the Rothschild Hours, is an important Flemish illuminated manuscript book of hours compiled in 105,000 by several artists. It contains 254 folios with each page size of 228 by 160 millimeters. Maybe the meaning of the book is lost on you. An illuminated manuscript book of hours is a manuscript or Christian devotional book that has psalms and prayers and where decorations or illustrations are made in gold and silver. It was purchased in 2014 by Australian businessman Kerry Stokes for $13.9 million. If you want to see this amazing work of art, it is on display in the National Library of Australia. Number 5. Bay Psalm Book. This is a metrical psalter printed in 1640 in Cambridge, Massachusetts. It was the first book printed in North America. The Psalms are written in a poetic structure and the translations are not particularly polished. It was translated from Hebrew as most people were not happy with the version. After a series of revisions, the last copy was made in the 18th century that was renamed the Bay Psalm Book. The selling point of this book is its rarity, with only 11 copies remaining, and 5 of them complete. A copy of this book was sold by Rubinstein in November 2013 for $14.5 million. Number 4. Saint Cuthbert Gospel. This is an early 8th century pocket gospel book of St. John written in Latin. It is beautifully decorated in leather binding, the earliest known Western book binding to survive, an outstanding condition for a book that is old. The book took its name from St. Cuthbert of Lindisfarne, northeast England. It was supposed to be placed in his tomb after his death in 687. It stayed in the tomb until it was removed in 1104 after a raid by Vikings. It stayed at Durham Cathedral and was kept with other relics, and important visitors were able to wear the book in a leather bag around their necks. Miraculously, this book found its way to the 21st century. It was sold for $15.1 million to the British Library. Number 3. Magna Carta Libertatum. This book is a royal charter of rights agreed to by King John of England at Runnymede, near Windsor, on June 1215. It was drafted to make peace between a group of rebels and the unpopular king. It promised church rights, access to swift justice, and protection for the barons against illegal imprisonment, among others. Neither side stood by the agreement. First Barons' War happened after Pope Innocent II annulled the charter. This made it lose its importance, but it has high historical value. Out of the 17 editions, only one survived. It was sold in 2007 to billionaire Ross Perot for $24.5 million. Number 2. The Gospels of Henry the Lion. These Gospels were intended to be placed at the altar of the Virgin Mary at St. Blaise Abbey Church in Brunswick. They were ordered by Henry the Lion, Duke of Saxony. It was made at the Benedictine Almerzine Abbey between the years 1175 and 1188. This volume is considered a 12th century masterpiece Romanesque book of illumination. The manuscript has 266 pages, 4 Gospels, and 50 of them full-page illustrations, with each illustration made of shimmering gold and vivid colors. In 1983, the book was purchased by the German government, backed by private donors, for an astounding price of $28 million. The book is displayed at the Herzog August Bibliothek in Wolfenbüttel once every 2 years for security reasons. It is still completely intact. I mean, who wouldn't want a multi-million book in their private library or bookcase? Number 1. Codex Leicester, Leonardo da Vinci. Also known as the Codex Hammer, the Codex Leicester is a book containing a collection of scientific writings by the popular Leonardo da Vinci. It is named after Thomas Coke, Earl of Leicester, who purchased it in 1719. It consists of 36 sheets and is leather-bound. It addresses a variety of issues such as why fossils of sea creatures are found in mountains, the movement of water, the luminosity of the moon, and advice on bridge construction and erosion measures. It is handwritten by Leonardo, using his mirror writing characteristics, and supported by copious diagrams and drawings. Each sheet is folded in half and bound together, but it is not displayed privately. This book made the record of the most expensive book ever sold when Bill Gates, founder of Microsoft, purchased it at $30.8 million in November 1994. Its value has only increased since then. Well, that is what we prepared for today. Let us know in the comment section below whether you think books are a luxury and how the future looks without them. Remember to give big thumbs up to this video, subscribe, and turn on that notification bell for more updates. Which book did you like the most? Let us know down below. For our readers, as they say in Italy, buona lettura. See you next time.